Immunotherapy with immune checkpoint inhibitors has revolutionized treatment for many different types of cancer. By unleashing the body's immune system to attack cancer, these therapies can send even the most hard-to-treat cancers into lasting remission. But these treatments also come with unique side effects that can affect multiple organs in the body. And because these treatments have entered the clinic fairly recently, many clinicians are not experienced in recognizing and treating these side effects. This is why the American Society of Clinical Oncology and National Comprehensive Cancer Network have collaborated on guidelines that offer clinicians much-needed recommendations for assessment and treatment of side effects related to immune checkpoint inhibitors. The major strength of the guidelines is to identify and manage side effects when they are just beginning and therefore much more manageable.
As immunotherapy starts getting into the community more and more, and we're treating more and more patients with these type of drugs, then trying to figure out how best to manage their side effects would be very important, as well as education of both the patients as well as caregivers and the physician and extended team.
The widespread use of immunotherapy is moving into standard clinical practice for lung cancer, for melanoma, for bladder cancer, for Hodgkin's disease, and therefore these agents are beginning to be widely used. They have a very different spectrum of side effects.
While fatigue is very common on immunotherapy, as it is also with chemotherapy, the immune therapy tends not to have direct side effects on the bone marrow. Patients tend not to lose their hair. So the mechanism of action of the immunotherapy is very important to know, because that can help guide you about, one, how to treat side effects that occur on immunotherapy, but also how to be aware of these type of side effects that can come up.
With the immune checkpoint inhibitors, we are removing the brake pedal from the immune system. Those brake systems are there for a reason. That is to prevent our immune system from attacking self. So when we remove those safety mechanisms from our immune system, we encounter all kinds of side effects that could be described as autoimmune side effects.
Patients are living a lot longer with immunotherapy. We're now facing the chronic toxicities of these drugs and how to manage them. So that's an important concept that we need to understand and need to approach in a very logical and sequential way.
We're seeing more and more cases of toxicity that result from these treatments. And so the guidelines are intended to address how to diagnose, recognize, and treat the side effects of immune checkpoint inhibitor therapy.
It is the goal of ASCO and NCCN guidelines to improve patient care by making clinicians aware of the side effects of immune checkpoint inhibitors and to guide them on how to best manage them.